What's happening? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with more Star Wars Jedi Outcast. Level 9, Nar Shaddaa Hideout. So, the first thing we're going to do straight away is jump up onto these pipes and up here for our very first secret area. Yeah, this soon in the level, out of 7. So yeah, we got, shields and ammo up here. And, look at our data pad, and we, obviously have to continue with tracking down Reelo Baruk. But, if we take a look at our force powers, we can see that force jump has now been upgraded to rank 2, and we can now leap up to 6 times our normal jump height. Alright. So, yeah, you'll be seeing me make a lot of use of force jump in this level, especially starting off here. So, yeah, in the corner we got this guy.
I'm not bad, just my master.
I'm not bad, just my master. Whatever you say, buddy. Anyway, let's head through here.
Phew, what is that smell?
Ah, that would be the smell of garbage. Filthy garbage. Yes, we're in Reelo's trash compactor compound, I guess, here. But anyway, you can push that out of the way. And the way to get started with this area is to run straight forward. And yeah, we have Grands up above us, but we'll deal with them when the time comes. We want to run over to here and jump up in here. Wait for the compactor to get out of the way. Get out of there before it crushes us. And head into this area here, and yeah, check it out. That's a long way down right there. So yeah, obviously we don't want to fall, and yes, there's a Rodian back there. We'll get him in a second. So we need to get over there, and to do it, you just jump over to here, and over to here, and you can grab, shields and a back-to-tank. And up this way, and up this way here. Alright, and we can move this box out of the way, and get up here like this. And yeah, you can just head on around the corner here, and we should find a Gran right here. Alright, hacked off his hand. Alright, sweet. So yeah, we can grab some ammo back here, and we can head across the bridge, and down this hallway here, and to the right. And at the end of the hallway, we will find that Rodian that I mentioned, so we can get rid of him. And right here, pull this trash cart towards you, because that's going to allow us to progress a little further on into the level. So, let's go ahead and head back the way we came here. Yeah, while I'm thinking about it, this level, it's interesting, because this level kind of switches gears from the last few levels, and that it's not, like, the last few levels, even as far back, and when you get out of here, make a right, then a left, and then a right, and then, go through this door here. But this level, it kind of changes things up, because the last few levels, specifically the Nar Shaddaa Streets level, and even as far back as the Artist Topside level, have all been kind of, spread out and wide open, and, full of outdoor areas that you can explore, whereas this level, it kind of, switches things up, and yeah, there's Secret 2, Secret 3 is right here, behind the boxes, behind the wall. You got some Rodians here. But yeah, this one's a lot more compact and, I guess...
Jeez, it's freezing in here.
Yeah, refrigeration unit. But yeah, this level is a lot more compact in that sense, and, just not really that wide open. We have, narrow hallways to explore, and, it's kind of more constricted, I guess. But anyway, yeah, hop through here, and get rid of him. And we can just head on down this hallway here. And right here, right up there, is secret number 4. And yeah, we got a shield booster in here if you need it. But anyway, yeah, that's an easy secret to miss, especially if it's your first time playing this level, because it's really well hidden. I gotta, you gotta give credit where credit's due. That's a very well hidden secret. But anyway, push this cart, and if you look ahead there, the cart ahead of this one is the one that we pulled earlier so that we could proceed into here. So let's get out a thermal detonator, and whoop, and let's see, let's force push that switch to open the door, toss one of these babies in there, nice, make quick work of him. Yeah, make sure you don't stay on that conveyor belt for too long, because it's hot to the touch, and Kyle will begin to take damage. So let's head on around here, and real quick, just head around, get rid of him. Whip out the bow caster here, because we're going to have some Grands up above that are going to throw thermal detonators down at us. And we do not want to get blown up. Come on, there we go. And that is all of them. So let's go ahead and head on down here. Yes, here's where the Rodians were that we got rid of before. Yeah, so we went the back way. But anyway, let's get rid of this guy. Or yeah, pull him down, slice him open. Same goes for him. And shoot this grate here. And blow all that stuff up down there. And that's going to allow us to proceed in just a second here. We'll head up there later. For right now, we'll go down this way. We got a weak way and two Rodians. So we'll just hack and slash here. And go through, yes. Break open the lock, go through our new entrance, and go through here.
Reelo sure has a lot of heavy firepower to guard a bunch of trash.
Sheesh, man, I know. I mean, God, look at this. What a dump. Anyway, let's, that goes back out into the main area, so we are going to head down into the bowels of Reelo's facility here. And, ooh, check this out. Looks like a holding area of sorts. Anyway, there's not much in this area straight away, except for in this little cell here. We're going to have we can pick up a seeker drone. And these little guys, these are basically like the training remotes that the Jedi used, you know, to basically, you know, train lightsaber skills and stuff like that. But, anyway, yeah, you can basically use them to fight alongside you against enemies, and they'll shoot them down and everything. I might show them off in a later level, but for right now...
Al-Katan?
Lando, what are you doing here?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm sitting in a cell. What about you?
I'm looking for Reelo Baruk.
You too? What's the Republic want with him?
A ship of his was involved in an incident on Artis Prime. Remnant stuff.
The Remnant? Blast. Now it's starting to make sense.
What?
Over the past few weeks, a mineral smuggling ring has infiltrated the Cloud City on Bespin. Real slick group, too. They commandeered half of our loading platforms and carbonite chambers before we knew what hit us. No one knows who's behind it, but it's become obvious that Reelo's garbage haulers are handling the transports. I came down here to find Reelo and persuade him to hand over the names of his employer.
Persuade?
Hey, I can be a charming guy when I want to. After a few bar fights and card games, I hadn't gotten any closer to Reelo, but I had begun to hear about a remnant bigwig named Desann. Then I was captured.
Desann?
You know him?
He's a dark Jedi. He and the Remnant have been performing sick experiments on New Republic citizens, among other things.
Like I said, the Remnant connection makes sense. These smugglers are much more organized than the kind of scum we usually get on Bespin. They've got to be Imperials.
Want me to get you out of here?
If it's not too much trouble. You'll need the password to get into Reelo's command center and open the cells.
Any idea what that might be?
Yeah, it's Ruby Bleel's.
I could go for one of those.
Yeah, me too.
I'll be right back.
I'm not going anywhere.
So Reelo is in Desann's pocket. It is all making sense now. But anyway, yeah.
I thought you were gonna get me out of here.
Oh, relax. I haven't even left yet. But anyway, yeah. Freaking Lando Calrissian is in this game. Yes, Lando from the original trilogy is in this game, and he's voiced by Billy Dee Williams, who played him in the movies. I just thought that was so cool when I first found that out. And with that, we obviously need to release Lando. So let's get to work on that. And, we can just head back here and, continue on with our little trek here. Just gonna go back the way we came, and, I don't need any of that ammo there. But we can jump up here, and, around this way, and we can, let's scale the wall. Ooh, nice. Anyway, we can head outside here, and, whoa, let's not get hit by that thermal detonator, shall we? Anyway, we got a whole lot of grands out here. And these guys... Oh, sheesh. Got hit. Keep getting hit by bombs, man. Oh, no. Use a back to tank. Go. Yeah, this, Oh, my gosh, look at how many bombs are out here. God. But, yeah, this area can be a little bit tricky. Can you... Okay, die, dude. Seriously. Anyway, yeah, there's a Rodian down there. There we go. tossed him around like a rag doll there. But anyway, yeah, this area can be a little bit tricky, but well, yeah, we're just going to jump down here, grab this back to tank and these shields, head up here. I've actually, in my failed attempt at recording this level, all these grands here actually appeared in that area we were just in back there. So yeah, it was a bit weird. They all just kind of came at me at once, and it was weird. I mean, that's when I died, of course, but it was just weird. They don't usually leave this area. Anyway, yeah, down here you can try and force pull this stuff, but yeah, it's just gonna get caught on the bridge. So to get to it normally, you just jump from those boxes to those boxes there. But I don't really need those items, so we're just going to proceed. And yeah, there's a detonation pack over there if you need it. But once again, I don't really need it, so we're just going to jump up here, shoot out the grate, and we can fall down into the office here. And, well, yeah. This door over here, this is where those grands were that were throwing down those thermal detonators at us. But, yeah. More importantly, right here...
Ruby Bleels.
Yes, Ruby Bleels. You need to talk to Lando before you try to get in here. Because yeah, if Kyle gets the password wrong, or if he just doesn't know, I think you get sent down into like some sort of pit of death, judging by that trap door there. Anyway, yeah, right here. Let this elevator go down. Use force speed quickly, and let's get rid of these guys here. Get rid of that Rodian. And that weak way way down there. Alright, he's dead. And with the stormtrooper right... Alright, yeah, I guess he's just spazzing out there. But yeah, with the stormtrooper rifle, I just like to get rid of these turrets. You can use either the stormtrooper rifle or the bowcaster here. But anyway... Alright, yeah, Rodian body is gone now. Anyway, back to this elevator here. We actually have a secret... Wait, well, I missed it, but... Yeah, we actually have a secret up here. Like that. Whoa, and I almost didn't make it out. But anyway, yeah, if you get stuck in there, the elevator will re-lower. But anyway, yeah, that's how you get through there. We're going to have two more active turrets around this corner here. And that was a Rodian that just, I'm guessing he cursed at us. But anyway, yeah, get rid of them two. And we'll break out the disruptor rifle. And let's see, let's vaporize this guy in the crotch here. Nice. So, right here, yeah, we have Rodians in these windows here. So, the way I like to do this, or the, well, yeah, preferred method, you can either do it this way, or you can just force pull them down and shoot them one at a time. Or you can play the crazy way and just go for them all at once. The problem with that is that you'll probably take a ton of damage. And... normally, in situations like that, I would like to play recklessly and just go guns blazing, but this is one of those games where you can't really do that, because it doesn't really work out. Very rarely can you go just gung-ho and do everything at once, but, yeah. And of course, given my history with games, that's definitely the way I like to play, but for this case, or in this case, I don't really mind doing it the systematic way. Anyway... push the switch, or force push the switch to get in here. You can pick up some more ammo, get some more shields. And we have plenty of health and ammo to get. You can take a look at the security feed if you want. And right here, we have a checkpoint, and if we go inside...
Looking for something?
Not anymore. You're Reelo Baruk?
In the flesh, but who are you?
Does it matter?
Not really. Any last words?
What's a respectable gangster like you doing mixed up with a remnant slime like Desann?
Making money, of course.
Alright, so what we want to do, because, yeah, we're going to have all these turrets that are going to start firing down at us, and we want to quickly take them out as fast as we can. I like to switch it up between the stormtrooper rifle and the crossbow. And this part isn't hard so much as it is annoying, because you constantly have to be running. But yeah, get rid of, yeah, once you get rid of all five of these turrets, like that, use force speed and quickly get rid of these frickin' weakways. Alright. Because there's gonna be a lot of them that come out of here. And you don't want to get, shot up by these guys. So get rid of them like that. And yes, after the weakway ambush, you can just go in here if you can, if you haven't gotten in here already, and just collect health and ammo. Now, interestingly, after the ambush there, take a look up there. Reelo Baruk is still up there. And, he's kind of, just overlooking everything that's going on. But, it looks like he doesn't really feel like talking, so let's go on in there and see if we can get him out of there. I like to go through the left door first, because that way, you can get rid of these Sniper Rodians, because there aren't any Sniper Rodians on this side. Well, there's one. But, die. Yeah, it just makes things a little easier, because there's more snipers on that side than this side. Anyway, if we head up here...
Where's Reelo? How could a Rodian that big just disappear?
Dude, I know. Where did he go? He was standing right here. There's only two ways into here, into this room, and then we went one way, and then we would have seen him go out the other way, right? Well, let's first of all hit this button here. Alright, so Lando has been freed, and, if you look down there, our next stop is that elevator platform down there that'll take us to the lower level. However, if we head back here...
Surveillance cameras? Reelo doesn't want to miss a thing.
Yeah, so if we look here, Lando obviously had no trouble dealing with that, that Rodian there. Anyway, we can, hit that switch, we have more power cell ammo, we can get back here... for another secret, and let's grab some shields. And instead of taking that elevator down, there's actually a much more fun way, and that's down the chute here. Whee! Anyway, you can just head on through the chute, and this is the way that Reelo took. But, we go through here, and with our disruptor rifle, let's aim down here. Oop! Come on. There we go. Get rid of him like that. And right in here, use force push on that switch there, and this is the final secret of the level. So just run on in here, grab all your stuff, and, head through here.
What went on up there?
I ran into Reelo.
Did he tell you anything about the smuggling ring?
We didn't talk much.
I see. Listen, we'd better get out of here. My ship's hidden nearby. What about yours?
Reelo's thugs have probably already stripped it for parts by now.
What about Jan?
Jan's not with me on this one.
You two have had another one of your fights, haven't you? Well, come on, let's go. You can buy some flowers on Bespin.
Oh, come on, Lando. Anyway, look at our data pad. All of our objectives are complete, so all we have to do is follow Lando to the star pad so we can get out of here on his ship. So, with that, let's go ahead and take this elevator up and end this level. Alright, that level wasn't too bad. We found all 7 secrets, which, is the most number of secrets out of any level in the game. And, we finally met up with Reelo Baruk. But, unfortunately he got away, so when we come back, we'll have to track him down even further in level 10, Nar Shaddaa Star Pad. We will finally be leaving Nar Shaddaa in the next level, so until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.